Good morning, children. Welcome to math class. How you all? I hope you all good. So in previous session we have discussed about solid shape. So now tell me, children, what shape it is? Yes, this is cube. And what shape it is, children? Yes, this is cuboid. Okay, what shape it is? Cuboid. And what shape it is, children? Cylinder. What shape it is? Cylinder. And what shape it is, children? Yes, this is sphere. We have discussed one more shape, cone. Okay, so now we have to check, children. Cube and cuboid having flat surface or curved surfaces? Yes, children. Cube and cuboid having only flat surfaces. Okay, only flat surfaces. Now check the cylinder, children. Cylinder having flat surface or curved surface? Yes, you have to check, children. This is curved surface. And if we place it like this, it stands. So this is flat surface and this is also flat surface. So cylinder have two flat surface, one, two, and one curved surface. Okay, children. Next, sphere. So sphere having flat surface or curved surface? It's curved surface, children. Sphere have one curved surface. Okay, children. And here cube and cuboid having six flat surfaces. Okay, cube and cuboid having six flat surfaces. Now I'll show, children. So this is one, and then back two, three, four, five, six. Okay, one, two, three, four, five, six. And yesterday we discussed, if we trace the object, what shapes we'll get. Also we discussed, children. So when we trace the cuboid, we'll get four rectangles and two squares. Yes, and when we trace the square, we'll get six squares. Now open page number 8, children. Open page number 8. The curved surfaces of object help them roll and the flat surfaces help them slide. Okay, the objects that are having flat surfaces, they can slide, and the objects that are having curved surface, they can roll. Next, look around your think room. Which solid shape is the room? So think room is our classroom. So what is the shape of our classroom, children? So once you have to check your rooms also, children. Okay, once you have to check your room, shape of our classroom is cuboid. Okay, what is the shape of our classroom? Cuboid. So once check your room, and you have to find what is the shape of your room, children. Okay, so write here cuboid. C-U-B-O-I-D, cuboid. Next, turn to next page. Identify the solid shapes of the famous building shown here. So what is the shape of this building, children? Yes, we can say very easily. Yes, what shape it is? Cylinder. So here you have to write cylinder. Next, what is the shape of this building? Yes, what shape it is? Sphere. What shape it is? Sphere, not circle. Okay, this is sphere shape. Next, which shape would you like to your house to be in? So which type to be like, which type, which shape would you like to your house be in, you have to write. So you have your house to be in cuboid shape or cube shape or like cylinder shape or sphere shape or cone shape, you have to write. Next, edges and corners. So now we are going to learn the next topic, children. Edges and corners. Okay, edges and corners. So listen, children. First, Ram is decorating a room. He has used given color code. Okay, here given one color code, children. So first here, yellow color. To color the lines where the two walls meet, here you have to color with yellow where the two walls meet. Here you have to check, children, where the two walls meet. For example, your room having four walls. Yes, this side and this side, and this is an opposite. So the total room have four walls. You have to color where the two walls meet. For example, you have to check, children. Here this is one wall and this is one wall. Yes, this is one wall and this is one wall. So here two walls met, no children. You have to color this line with using yellow color. Okay, you have to color this line with using yellow color. Here I wrote yellow. Why? And here also, children. Here this is one wall and this is one wall. Here do these two walls meet? Met. Here you have to color with yellow color. Okay. This line you have to color with yellow and this line also you have to color with yellow. Next, to color the lines where the wall and the floor meet. Okay, you have to color the wheels. You have to color with using red color where the wall and floor meet. So the floor it is down and wall. You have to check, children. This is floor. No, where the wall and floor met? Yes, children. This is wall and this is floor. Here the wall and floor met. No, you have to color with red. And here also this is wall and this is floor. So here you have to color with red color. I'm writing red. And here also, children, this is wall and this is floor. You have to color with red color. Next, green color. Third one, green. To color the lines where the wall and ceiling met. Okay, you have to color the walls where the wall and ceiling met. So just if we see your room, you can observe clearly, children. Yes, where the wall and ceiling met, children. Yes, this is wall and this is ceiling. Also here you have to color with green color. And this is also wall. So this is also wall and it met ceiling. So you have to color with green. It's already colored with green. So like this you have to color, children. These two you have to color with yellow. Why? Here where the two walls meet, you have to color with yellow. So that's why. Next, red. To color the lines where the wall and floor meet. So here these three, the wall and floor met. So you have to color these three with red color. And to color the lines where the wall and ceiling met, here these three, the wall and ceiling met. So use the same color. Next page, children, page number 10. Use the same color code to color the remaining lines where the floor, walls and ceiling met. So we colored remaining also, children. So first here we colored with yellow color where the two walls meet. And the second one we use red color to color where the walls and floor meet. And the third we use green color to color where the ceiling and walls meet. So next here, turn to next page, children. The walls, floor and ceiling are the six surfaces of Ram's room. The room is in the shape of cuboid. So just now I said, no children, here this is the shape of cuboid. Okay, this room is the shape of cuboid. So here totally six surfaces are there. Now I will show these six surfaces, children. Okay, this is cuboid. No, so first this is one surface. Okay, this is one surface and opposite two. One, two. And here this is one surface. Three, four. Three, four. And the above one, five, six. Okay, totally six surfaces, children. One, two, three, four, five, six. So totally cuboid have six surfaces. Next, the red, yellow and green lines are the edges where the two surfaces meet. Okay, the red, yellow and green lines are the edges where the two surfaces meet. Edges may be curved or straight. Okay, cuboid have all straight edges only, children, not curved. Cuboid have all straight edges. Next. Okay, children, so now I'll show the edges. So total how many edges are there? So in this room you have to check, children. You color with green, yellow and pink. No, so these are edges. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So total these 8 are edges. This is cuboid shape, children. So now I will show edges. Okay, this is one. Okay, one, two, three, four. Okay, children. One, two, three, four. Next, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, so total how many edges, children? Eight. So now count remaining also, children. So here you have to count nine. This is also one edge. 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so total cuboid have how many edges? 12 edges, children. So here you have to check. This is one edge, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the first these four, and then in the 5, 6, 7, 8, and this is 9, 10, 11, 12. So the cuboid have totally 12 edges. Here you have to check, children. And here given cylinder. So cylinder. So these two are the edges of cylinder, children. Okay, these two are the edges of cylinder. So cylinder having curved edge or straight edge, children? Yes, you have to check. This is curved edge or not? Yes, cylinder having curved edges. Okay, cylinder having curved edges. Okay, is it clear? Cylinder having curved edges. Cylinder having curved edges. Okay, this is the shape of cube. This is cube shape, children. So now we'll find corner, children. So how we have to find corners? So the corner means the points where two edges meet. Okay, the point where two edges meet. Yes, we know that, children. This is one edge. This is one edge. So these two meet at this point. So this is corner. And here this is one edge and this is one edge. So these two meet at this point. So this is corner. And here this is one edge and this is one edge. So these two meet at this point. So this is corner. And here, children, you have to check this edge and this edge meet at this point. So this is one corner. And here you have to check. This is one corner. This is one corner. This is one corner. And this is one corner. So the corner means where the two edges meet. Here you have to check, children. This is one edge and this is one edge. So this is corner. Okay, this is corner. These two edges meet at this point. So this point is corner. Okay, this point is corner. And here also you have to check, children. This edge and this edge and this edge meet at this point. Okay, this edge and this edge meet at this point. So this is corner. So the total how many corners? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, you have to remember, children. Cube and cuboid have 8 corners. Okay. Cube and cuboid have 8 corners. So now in 1.10 you have to check, children. Draw balloons at every corner of the room to decorate it. Okay, draw balloons at every corner of the room to decorate it. So just now we learned, children, what means corner. Where the two edges meet at this point, this point is called corner. Okay, where the two edges meet, this is called corner. So now here you have to check this room, children. Yes, where the two edges meet. Yes, here this edge and this edge meet at this point. So this is corner. Next, we have to check, children. This edge and this edge meet at this point. So this is corner. Here you have to draw balloons, children. Next, this edge and this edge meet at this point. So here you have to draw one balloon. Draw balloons. And here this edge and this edge meet at this point. So this is also corner, children. Here also you have to draw balloons. Like that, you have to draw balloons in these four corners. Okay, corner means where the two edges meet at this point. So here this is one edge and this is one edge, children. So these two edges meet at this point. So here you have to draw balloons. And here this is one edge and this is one edge. These two edges meet at this point. So this is one corner and this is one edge and this is one edge. These two edges meet at this point. So this is corner. And here this is one edge and this is one edge. These two edges meet at this point. So here you have to draw balloons here. Where the two edges meet, this is corner, children. So that's why here we draw balloons. So now open page number 4 in companion, children. So everyone open companion page number 4. Tick to show whether the object has flat surface, a covered surface or both. Okay, what you have to do here, children? You have to see objects here given, list of objects: orange, pencil and measuring jug, onion, and here it is the shape of cylinder and it is eraser. So here given object, you have to tick the shape. These are having flat surface or curved surface or both. So for example, here first given orange, children. So orange having flat surface or curved surface? Yes, orange having only curved surface. Just you have to tick curved surface. So like that, here next here given pencil, children. You have to check the pencil having flat surface or curved surface or both. So like that you have to tick. Okay, like that you have to tick. If the objects are having only flat, means you have to tick the flat surface, and the objects are having only curved surface, means you have to tick the curved surface, and they are having both, means you have to tick option both. Okay, children. So in today's class we have discussed about edges and corners. Okay, edges and corners. So edges means where the two surfaces meet, we call an edge. Okay, where the two surfaces meet, we call edge. So this is cuboid, children. So cuboid have how many edges? Now I'll show. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1. So first see like this, children. This 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, 6, 7, 8, and it is 9, 10, 11, 12. So total cuboid have 12 edges, children. So total cuboid have 12 edges. And coming to the corner, children, you have to check here. These two edges meet at this point. Am I correct? These two edges, this is one edge and this is one edge. These two edges meet at this point. So this is corner. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1, 2. These are corners, children. This is edge. Okay, this total is edge. This point is only corner. 1, 2, 3, 4. So again back. 5, 6, 7, 8. So totally these are having 8 corners and 12 edges. Just you have to remember this, children. So tomorrow we'll discuss more about corners and edges, and you have to complete the homework companion page number 4 1 way, children. Thank you. Have a nice day.